Hi and welcome back. Today I am going to show you how to design a helical bevel gear using SolidWorks 2022. By watching this SolidWorks tutorial, you will learn the technique of designing helical bevel gear like a professional. By watching this tutorial, you will learn the use of SolidWorks feature tools like sketch rotation, sketch scaling, loft, revolve boss, boss extrude, circular pattern, etc. Hope you will stay connected with us and continue learning advanced part modeling by SolidWorks 2022. Hope you will love the way we design the helical bevel gear by using SolidWorks 2022. So, let's get started. We'll go straight to SolidWorks. First select plain white from the apply scene option. Now select material from the material menu. Let's select brass. You can choose whatever you like. Apply and close. First, click on the right plane and start the sketch. We gonna use the line tool to draw the profile for creating the gear shaft, by using revolve command. First, draw a vertical line. Then go right. Then go down. Follow the procedure I am using. Return to the start point to convert the line command into arc command. Make sure this point is slightly below the arc starting point. You will find that the arc command automatically changed into a line command. Now draw lines like me, till the finish of the first profile. Now right-click the blank space, hold on, and drag to open the mouse gesture. Select smart dimension. The height is 45 millimeters. This length is 5 millimeters. This length is 163 millimeters. This height is 30 millimeters. The distance is 30 millimeters. Put this dimension is 52 millimeters. This distance is 100 millimeters. This distance is 110 millimeters. This height is 40 millimeters. This one is 38 millimeters. This one is 35 millimeters. Perfect, the sketch is fully defined. Let's use revolve boss command to complete the gear shaft. Select this line as revolve axis. Press OK to complete the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. We will create three identical profiles to create the helical bevel gear. First profile on the surface. And the remaining two profiles are on two separate planes. Left click on the face and select sketch. Take circle command and draw two circles like me. Use dimension. The diameter is 170 millimeters. This one is 100 millimeters. Take line command and draw a line like me. Right click and select construction geometry. Now take the 3-point arc command and draw an arc, like me. Use dimension. The distance is 6 millimeters. And this distance is 15 millimeters. The radius of the arc is 65 millimeters. Now use the mirror entity command. Select this arc. Mirror about this axis. Now trim unwanted lines. Let's use the circular pattern command. Select this edge. Select these arcs and the line as pattern entities. The degree of rotation is 360 and the number of instances is 8. Press OK to complete. Perfect. Now use the trim command to remove all unwanted lines. Press the space button and select isometric view. Exit from the sketch. Now we will create a plane parallel to the surface. The distance is 50 millimeters. Now left click on the plane and select sketch. Now use convert entities to copy the previous sketch. From the sketch menu select scale entities. Click into the area to select all the arcs with one click. Select the origin as the scale about point. The scale factor is 0.75. Perfect. Now we will rotate the sketch. Select all the arcs by clicking on the sketch. Select Rotate command from the sketch menu. Select origin as the center of rotation. The rotation angle is 15 degrees. Exit the sketch. Press Ctrl plus 8. Now select the front plane and take plane command. Create a parallel plane and the distance is 100 millimeters. Left click on the plane and select sketch. Press Ctrl plus 8. Use the convert entities command for making the third profile. Select the first profile. Perfect. Press Ctrl plus 8. Hide the second profile. Now take scale command. Click inside the profile to select all the arcs at once. Select origin as the scale origin point. The scale factor is 0.5. Press OK to complete the command. Now take rotate entities command. Select all the arcs. Keep relations. Select origin as the rotation center. The angle of rotation is 30 degrees. Press OK to complete the command. Press Ctrl plus 8. Now show sketch 3. Exit from the sketch. Hide plane 2. Now we gonna use the loft command using these 3 sketches. Select these corners like me. Hide these sketches for a cleaner look. This is the helical bevel gear. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now left click on this surface and select sketch. Take the rectangle command and draw a rectangle like me. Make sure that the starting corner of the rectangle is coincident with the circle. Make this corner coincident too. The width of this arm is 9 millimeters. Make the origin and the midpoint of the line vertical. Also, this distance is 41 millimeters. The sketch is fully defined, and ready for extruding. Reverse the direction. The extrude distance is 52 millimeters. Press OK to exit the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. Left click on the edge and select chamfer. Chamfer distance is 1 mm and angle 45 degrees. Select this edge too. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now we gonna sue the circular pattern command to copy this extruded part. Select the boss extrude and chamfer for the pattern. Select this face for pattern direction. The instances of the pattern are 13. Press OK to exit the command. Now we gonna extrude cut the shaft. Sketch on this surface. Draw a circle like me. The diameter is 35 millimeters. Take extrude cut command. Select through all. Press OK to exit the command. Finally, we will chamfer this edge. Chamfer distance is 1 mm and the angle is 45 degrees. Select this edge too. Press OK to exit the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. Congratulations! This is the final helical bevel gear that we were trying to build using SolidWorks 2022. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you are watching this video on Facebook, please like and share. Because your engagement encourages me to upload new tutorials. Please also let me know your thought about this tutorial through comments. Thanks for your time.